at eligibility criteria. Number one, first thing, your minimum age must be 21 years completed. When in the year you are appearing for examination, suppose you are appearing for examinations in year 2022, then on 1st of August 2022, your minimum age should be 21 years on or before. Whereas maximum age criteria are different. So first criteria, that is age criteria, that is minimum age 21 years. Second criteria, you must be a graduate, minimum education for this examination, that is graduate from UGC recognized university. Whereas third important thing, that if you are not graduate but you are appearing for graduation examinations that last year you are there, then also you can apply for this examination. The condition is that prior to mains examination you must have degree in your hand. So this is about the educational criteria. So minimum education required for this, that is graduation from UGC recognized university. Now many students are having doubts in their mind that whether diploma holders can apply for this examination. Answer is no. You must have minimum degree. That is the important condition here. Now another question that is also we are facing continuously, that whether doctor or engineer can apply for civil services examination. Answer is yes, they can apply. Along with their respected examination, they can apply for civil services examinations. Now, eligibility criteria, we discuss about age, we discuss about minimum qualification. The most important thing, you must be a citizen of India. Now, I am not going to discuss all these clauses, but that minimum thing, in that you must be citizen of India. Now, upper age limit. So, upper age limit is different for different communities. If you are belonging to open community, then upper age limit is of 32 years. Again, when age is find out that the you are going to appear for examination, in that year, 1st of August, your age is considered. And so, 32 years is maximum age limit for open category. For OBC category, if you belong to OBC category, you are aware, but not, then I must let you aware that you must have non-crimilier certificates. Then only you are considered as OBC, otherwise you have to fill the form like open category only. So please be aware that while applying, you must have OBC certificate, that whatever the requirements, plus that non-crimilier certificate should be there, then only you are considered as OBC, otherwise you are considered as open category. So for OBC, it's 35 years. Whereas for SC and ST candidate, it is 37 years. Next question, how many times a person can appear for this examination? That is, what are the number of attempts for this UPSC civil services examination? Answer, again category wise, if you are belonging to open category, you have 6 attempts total. Now old video, if you are going to observe, there we mentioned that if you are going appearing in examination center and once you are signing that you are present, then it is considered as your attempt. But now they have changed out. Now the policy is that once you are applying for examination, that is considered as your attempt. So now be aware that don't apply blindly. If you are thoroughly prepared or you are having that confidence, yes, I'm going to appear for exam, then only apply. Otherwise, don't apply, because now application is considered as your attempt. So that is the change in old video and this new video. So what number of attempt for open category, 6 attempts are there. within the given time. That is 21 years minimum age, 32 years maximum age. In between that, you can attempt 6 times this examination. Whereas, if you belong to OBC category, that means you have now non-criminal certificate and all that valid, then you have more attempts that you can appear for total 9 attempts you can have. So 9 times you can appear. Age limit, as we discussed, that for OBC category it's 35 years. So from 21 to 35, in between that you can appear 9 times. Whereas for SC and ST candidate, you can appear unlimited attempt. That means between 21 years to 37 years, every year you can appear. I hope this type of, I'm giving the maximum number of attempts. But if you are studying properly, then no need to appear for so many attempts. That is the another thing. But what is my duty? That I must give the exact what the procedure is there. So this is the way we can discuss about number of attempts.